Hello friends, welcome back to another video. In this video, we want to learn how to focus a microscope, okay? Because this is one of the most important instrument that you're going to use in the lab. Whether you are from zoology, microbiology, botany, physiology, you're going to use microscope for a life science student, as a life science student, okay? For any biological background. But most of the people I found can't handle microscope well. Okay, so whatever microscope it can be a simple microscope, like simple in the sense a compound microscope, but in a simple version, the old version, or a newer modern version like this, a binocular or trinocular microscope, the part of focusing a microscope is different. So in this video, we want to talk about how to focus a microscope properly. Okay, so without talking too much about it, I'm going to take this camera in my hand. I'm going to show you how exactly we're talking about the focusing of a microscope. Here you can see the microscope stages, okay? You may not see my face. You may not see my face here. But this is where we are going to talk about setting up microscope. Okay, let me put the microscope camera something like this. This is how I'm going to explain the process quite easily now, okay? So you can see these are the ocular, the eyepiece lenses where you can see things, okay? And these are the lenses, the objective lenses. Four lenses are out there, whatever number of lenses may be present there. One is 10x, one is 6x here, and 240x in this case. Okay, so these are all the stages out here. Okay, the mechanical stages, you probably have seen. This is the stage and these are the ruler with which we can simply position the slide. Now, the biggest problem people, the biggest issue, the mistakes people do about focusing a microscope is that they are going to, let's say this is a slide, okay, this is the algae, plain algae slide. I'm going to put the slide in here like this. The slide is in the position. Now the second step, the very second, this is the first step, putting the slide into the stage. The step number two is adjusting the specimen according to the objective lens where you want to focus. For example, if you look at this picture, I don't know whether you can see it, I can zoom into the image. If I zoom in, you can see here, let me zoom in a bit, yes, here you can see that this is our sample, this is where the sample is and this is the lens, 40x lens, the steel lens, this is the 40x lens. So our sample is not exactly aligned to the lens, so what we are going to do, we are going to align it properly first. So this is the alignment as per our own vision, okay, we are not going to see the vision in field, okay. Because if you want to see the vision in field, it's going to take more time. So just put it approximately in the vision. Okay, that's done. Once this is done, let me zoom out. Okay, once that thing is done, then what we're going to do, this is a 40x lens we're talking about. Now remember one thing. If you are looking something under the microscope with 10x objective, okay, the distance between the slide and the objective is far. It's that much of distance. Approximately this much of distance. The more you handle the microscope, you get better with this idea of the distance. Okay, but with 40x, the distance between the slide and your lens will be very, very low. That's why it's more critical to adjust a 40x microscope objective lens compared to a 10x objective lens. Okay, not an issue. So what we're going to do here, we're going to see a 40x lens. So what we're going to do now, many people put their eye here like this and they start putting the lens up. They start taking the stage up because stage is the thing which goes up and down. So people just look into this binocular or it's a monocular, whatever situation it is, they are going to see the ocular and then they are going to rotate rotate the screw. Okay, either the major and micro, both the screw. This is the biggest mistake that you can do while focusing a microscope, because if you do that, there is a chance that the objective will hit the lens and the objective will hit the slide, sorry, and the slide can be cracked. The first thing, the slide will be cracked. Although in the objective, there is a spring in the lens so that the objective lens cannot get broken due to some extent. But still, the objective lens also can acquire some damage. So what you need to do, remember that this is my style of focusing. So I'm going to zoom in again. Here you can see, zoom again, this is the place. So what we are going to do, we are going to I've just the screw. Here is the screw. You can see in this side. Let me go a little. So this is the screw, right? So we are going to take the screw by looking into the gap that is present between the lens. You can probably see that the lens and the slide. This is the slide. This is the lens. Okay. So we are going to bring them up like this. We are going to see that and bring it up like this. This is a very, very important. You can see that it's going down. The stage is going up. And we are not going to do that while looking into the ocular. What we are going to do, we are going to see here. Let me zoom out. So what we are going to do that manually, look into the distance between the objective lens and the slide. And then we are going to take it up as much as up we can go. Okay. As much up we can go. We are going to see that, look that, and we are going to see that. So let me zoom in a little bit so that you can understand a little bit more. Yeah, like that. So I'm going to get up. This is down. We are going to get up as maximum as we can until the lens hits the slide. We will go. We will slide to it. We are not going to see anything about the field. Whatever field we are getting, it's not, it doesn't matter. We're going to just see that. And at maximum distance that we can go. The minimum distance we can achieve between the lens, the objective lens and the slide, that is the point we should go and we should stop. That's done. Till this point, we haven't put our eye into the eyepiece. Okay, we just reached there. Now what we will do? Now, let me zoom out. So the adjustment is done. So this lens means this stage cannot go up further without touching the lens. We know that the maximum limit is achieved. Now what we will do, we are simply going to course adjust it. Course adjust, you can see the course adjustment screw little bit down here. I think you can see this is the course adjustment screw. This is the one. This is the the course adjustment is done. The fine adjustment, this is the one. Now we are going to do the fine adjustment, no course adjustment. It's already done. So now we are going to do the fine adjustment. And remember, when you turn it toward yourself like this, you are going to take the slide, take the stage down away from the lens. When you're rotating outwards in your side, this side like this, then you are going to take the stage up close to the lens. If your eyepiece is forwarding you in this kind of binocular microscope. Okay. So we are never going to do this like in your side. We are always going to do this side. Reverse meaning our side. Okay. So we are simply going to do that by putting our eye in the eyepiece until we see a proper clearly visualized image. This is the way to focus a microscope the best possible way. Believe me, if you try this couple of times, you'll never ever need anyone to help you adjusting a microscope. And you will never ever damage a single specimen slide or objective lens with the help of this process. This is the best process that is available, that is there to focus a microscope like a professional. In my cases, when I was in the college, graduation and post-graduations, all my friends asked me to focus the microscope for them. I always see in the exam time also, they couldn't find the field of view properly. But it's not that difficult. You can just follow these steps that I told you and you can easily focus a microscope. And not only that, but with the help of a light microscope, we can take images leaps and bounds ahead. You can't even imagine. Even we can get very high contrast images, looks a kind of pseudo 3D images with the help of a light microscope. Do you want to know how we can do that? For that, you need to watch all our microscopy videos that we're going to post in this channel. So subscribe to our channel to get more and more videos like that, because we're going to show you every single details, every single tricks to get different kinds of images of a single specimen with the help of a microscope. Okay, so that is how you can focus a microscope. That's the best way to focus a microscope, whether you use a binocular, a trinocular or any monocular microscopes. The old microscopes used to do the similar things. If I show you one, my old microscope is in here. This was my old microscope. And the thing goes same, okay? There's no ruler or anything in here. Just simply put, this is the lens, this is the eyepiece lens, you know. But still, whatever thing you put there, you put the slide in and then you are going to rotate. There's no objective lens connected here yet. It's not present there. I just opened them up. But still, again, you can see this is the coarse adjustment and this is the fine adjustment. So you need to do that, okay? You need to bring them as max you can, then slowly take the coarse adjustment to up and focusing it properly, okay? And one more thing, you can see a screw present here. I don't know whether you can see it. Let me zoom in a little bit. It's too much. You can see this screw that is present here, this screw. Now this screw is designed in a way to prevent the loss of specimen slide and loss of the objective lens, because if you tighten this screw, the more you tighten the screw, the less this objective lens is going to come down. The same thing is also present in case of this this other microscopes, this binocular microscopes as well. I'm going to show you that too. Here also there is a screw. I don't know if you can see that or not. This is where the screw is present, okay? We can make this screw tight or less so that we can protect the stage to reach a certain level. That we can do. One more tip that I must share. While you're focusing a microscope, you should not, like for example, you want to see a specimen at a bigger magnification, let's say 40x objective magnification. In that case, you should not use the 40x objective magnification at the very beginning. You should start with lower magnification. Start with 10x objective magnification, because in 10x the field of view will be bigger, and if your sample contains a lot of the specimen that you are going to see, then you can directly go with the bigger magnification, because you are going to find your specimen because of the higher density. But if your specimen density is low in the sample, in that case, start with a lower magnification, because it will give you a bigger field of view. And then in the bigger field of view, you point out the places where your specimen is present. Then shift it from the smaller magnification to the larger magnification or bigger magnification, from 10x to the 40. Okay. And then you are going to see the bigger image of the specimen that is present there. Okay. Keep this idea. For example, if you are looking into the white blood cell in a blood specimen, which is rarely present, okay, red blood cell you can see directly under 40x objective. But for white blood cell, first find them out using a 10x, a place of the slide where more 3-4 white blood cells are present. Then shift the magnification from 10x objective to 40x. Then you are going to see the white blood cells presence very clearly. So this is the way to focus, to upgrade your focus level, okay? That's all about how to focus a microscope for a proper viewing, okay? And this is regarding the movement of stage, aligning the specimen through the light path, okay? This is the only thing that you need to do. And the lighting and all, I have not talked about that, because we have already discussed about that in the details of microscopy and the parts and uses of the microscopic parts in the earlier video, right? So that's all for today. Thank you. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to our channel to get more videos like that. Thank you. Bye.